Hello and welcome to this, the MTC webinar. The MTC, perhaps I should more correctly say, is representing of Manufacturing Team Challenge. And I highlight the word team because this competition requires three people be involved. And we'll talk about the skill range that's necessary in a few moments. My name is Wynne Rowlands and I'm the Manufacturing Team Challenge expert for the UK and the international events. Okay, so let's go back to the competition itself, which is in three parts. The first part of the competition is a main project, and this is where everybody seems to put their focus. But added to that, there's also two portfolios that have to be produced, and those will show costings and computer-aided drawings of the specification that you're manufacturing. And finally, there is the surprise project element, which is where we actually test the skills. So if we go back to the first part of the competition, which is the main project, carrying 40% of the weighting, this is a design and manufacture. So what you will get is a specification, and from that specification, you come up with your design. So if we take something very simple like a car, does it have to have four wheels? Does it have to have three wheels? Could it have a four engine cylinder, a six engine cylinder? Those questions are what need to be answered to meet the specification. So from the specification, you will design a piece of equipment that will meet that spec in full. This is going to need, obviously, design, some computer-aided CAD experience to source the drawings and make the drawings for that, and then all the necessary skills, which could involve fabrication, electronics, machine shop skills to manufacture that piece of equipment. So a complete package within itself, but yet only carrying 40% of this competition brief. Further to that, there are two portfolios. And in the first portfolio, which you actually bring to the competition, you will obviously have a team profile in there. You will have some calculations to show why you've used various components in your design and how they meet the requirements of the specification. And also, you will have a full series of costings of the materials that you are going to use in manufacturing that main project. The other portfolio, Portfolio B as it's referred to, is a portfolio that you produce during the competition. And this actually is just a portfolio showing all the computer-aided drawings that you've used to manufacture that main project. And then finally, what we move on to is the surprise project. And in the surprise project, we test then your range of skills in anything and everything that is in the description of the Manufacturing Team Challenge. So that could involve anything from sheet metal to welding, from center lathe turning to drilling to bench fitting and to electronics assembly and fault finding. So that in itself will carry 30% of the weighting at the national competition. So what skills are actually required? Well, if we look through them and just try and create a synopsis there, obviously CAD-CAM knowledge, knowledge of design and manufacturing techniques. And because of that, quite often this competition does target young people who are in perhaps the latter part of their apprenticeships, 19, 20 year olds, although we do have younger teams on times, and they may sort of seek advice within their own companies as regards to the design in the first instance. Obviously, having designed and set up your set of drawings to manufacture this piece of equipment to meet the specification, you will then actually need to go through whatever series of manufacturing operations are necessary, working together as a team to get the most effective cycle time in building that piece of equipment, and remembering when we talked about costings as we've got in portfolio A, time in terms of times on machines, and also time as in terms of the amount of time taken to make the project, all come into the total evaluation for the competition. So the areas that will be tested, or the skill areas that will be tested, definitely will be CAD and CAM. We will definitely be looking at fabrication in terms of sheet metal and welding. We will definitely be looking at center lathe turning and drilling, tapping, and a certain amount of bench fitting activity. And we will certainly be looking at electronics. And all those components will come not only, and I'm not saying not only because they might not all come within your own main project, but they will certainly likely come within the surprise project, which is when we actually test the skill base. And obviously we're looking at how you manage that surprise project in terms of time, and how you integrate it with the manufacturer of the main project. So a team effort, and also in terms of the main project, it is useful to bear in mind that it is better if at least two people can do a number of the operations in build, should that one person be needed to be taken out for an enlarged amount of time to work on the surprise project. That's something that we can talk about when we meet at a future date. So let's go through the competition stages. Well, first of all, it's worth having a look at the competition overview and the specification that we're going to be building this year. And if we look at the specifications, I'll just look back on the last 2 years and what we're doing this year. But 2 years ago, the main competition, that was the 40% competition, that was with regards to a forklift truck. Last year, we built a recovery vehicle, something that the military might use or the police might use to sort of recover a bomb or a suspect item in a suspect situation. We also said that that piece of equipment could be used for moon or outer space exploration in terms of the fact that it could be remotely controlled. And this time our main project is going to be centered around a locomotive which could be used in a shunting yard situation and would be remotely controlled and could be totally automated to move loads through a series of conditions and offload in a further place down the track. We'll be looking at that in terms of its efficiency and the amount of material that can be moved in a given amount of time. So that gives you some idea of the things that will come into the specification, and obviously you need to read those clearly. So step two is register online between the 1st of March and the 7th of April, and you obviously need to do that on WorldSkills UK website. And I suggest, if you're keen on this, that you get together as a group of three. You make sure you involve your line managers and you tell them exactly what you're going to do, and get your registrations in as soon as possible. Following the registrations, I will invite the teams to a project planning event, probably in April, certainly no later than very early May. And I will outline then the competition more fully to you so that you can go away knowing fully what's going to be expected in producing the main specification or the main project for this competition. Having gone to that project planning event, you can then go away, work on your designs, and bring something back to the table by June, which gives us some idea of what you're doing. Will it meet the spec? Are you on the right tracks? Can we give you some words of wisdom at that stage, which will take you forward into the further development of the project? and prepare yourselves to come forward to a regional event in early September, at which time we will test all the units that have been built to the specification. And it's at that stage that you will see that this competition has got its own unique features, in that you've all read the same specification, but you will all have something different to do the job. And we will be looking for the best four and possibly the best six teams to go forward to Birmingham in November of this year, when the national finals will be held at the NEC. So how are you going to prepare? Read the competition brief, or the specification as I've referred to it earlier on. The competition rules, know what's expected of you, and again, I'll reiterate that we will go through those when we meet up in late April, early May time. You are responsible for planning and managing the project and sourcing most of the materials to manufacture the project. So it's not a case of coming to a competition and everything's on the table for you to start to make it to drawing. The only thing that you will make to drawing that's given to you will be the surprise project. So you will design, create your own drawings, source your materials, and come to the competition in a position to be able to build that piece of equipment. So obviously this is going to call for you to manage your time efficiently. And anything that you're asked to do in terms of briefing meetings, that you turn up promptly and you see the importance of those in terms of the competition. Any questions that you have on the way, well, I'm your first point of contact as the manager for the event, and you will get that detail obviously off the webinar here. Together with any details that you might feel you need from SEMTA, who are the sponsoring agent for this piece of competition, and also WorldSkills UK, and you can enter their webinars using the addresses given you. So what benefits come out of it for you as individuals? Well, the competitions I've been involved in over the last 6 years now, I've noticed that it's enhanced the individual's capability. It's give you a chance to rise your own personal profile, to compete in a national competition and on a national stage. It gives you development and training opportunities over and above what you'd have in your apprenticeship and on your college courses. And if they're for the successful ones amongst you who come forward to Birmingham and finish in the top three, there will be the applause obviously of a closing event similar to what we get in the Olympic Games, where a gold, silver and bronze medal will be awarded. So a lot of benefits there. And you might say, well, the company said, what's in it for them? And it's interesting to note that the young people that's been through it, and with some of those companies, the companies now make sure that they enter this competition as a means of development of their apprentices, because we found that young people now, as young as 21 or 2, are sort of going into jobs which they wouldn't expect to get to until they're 25 or 6, having taken back in this taken part in this competition. So it is a good building block in your own personal career. And it's also something that's very useful to have on the bottom of your CV. We're sponsored by most of the large companies, and the competition itself was once declared the Rolls-Royce of all competitions in the NEC. And it's interesting that Rolls-Royce, BAE Systems, Siemens, Jaguar Land Rover, to name but a few, sponsor this event. So finally, if there's anything that you need, remember, my details are there. Please get in touch with me. But first and foremost, read your specifications and get your registrations in as quickly as possible. Until we meet again, all the very best, chaps. Cheers for now.